I think I see it more clearly today than I did then. And secondly, and this is the more important point, I think we were wrong.
Requiem for Strange Bedfellows. Nam, or better yet, Vietnam. The West, South, North, ideologies collide, breaking, wrecking, fragile alliances, unwarped parchments, as invectives were hurled back and forth by generals, nearsighted diplomats that sought not to exhale, rather leading to swift, abrupt, agonizing death. Now the Gorgiles, the Banshees, demons, wail, terrifying the subconsciousness with visions of nightmares of a hideous and obscene time, place, and date that has etched, immortalizing the decadence so firmly cemented in a substance called memory. Conflict has no reverence for the silver chalice. As death never leaves, never goes away, a lawless assassin, totally indifferent toward its opposition, forever demanding more and more and more human sacrifice of humanity, executing in the name of peace, brotherhood, and liberty. Thus, in mud-filled holes of teeming tropical heat, the stench of death, putrid flesh rotting as mosquitoes, flies, maggots abound, as scavengers of justice, some no more than under 20, killed, murdered, not for what they did, but because of war, in war, at war, in a conflict. Many slept in trenches or foxholes, side by side, ate from the same table, or drank from the same cup. And yet, America slept its natural, nocturnal, beleaguered sleep. Homo sapiens slept the sleep of Debussy's Clair de Lune. As the forgotten Homo sapien returned home to the soil of their nativity, as strangers in absentia, no roar of nor from the crowd, nor the blare of trumpets, nor the fluttering of ticker tape for its unwelcome sons that were truly the strange bedfellows as the parade passed them by.